Welcome back, everyone. Looks like we're getting close to having everybody on. Hopefully that was a good chance to just check in with some highs and lows with a couple folks. I did just hit the record button, so we are going to record again our Zoom call tonight. So anyone that did miss it will have a chance to catch up a little bit later. So. Again, thanks for being part of this tonight. It's great to see you all. This is the last night we're meeting for content as we get ready and prepare for confirmation. The next times we'll be gathering will be to share your faith statement and expressions of faith, to do some photos, and to get ready for the confirmation service itself. So that is coming up, but until we get there, this is our last night. And tonight we're going to be talking about our spiritual gifts. So maybe not something you've talked about before. Maybe it is. Maybe it's something you've gone into depth before. But I think it's just a really neat way to look at what God is doing in our lives and how do we kind of figure out what that is and where our gifts and talents meet the world's needs. So it's hopefully kind of a neat and cool thing for you. If you did stop by Emmanuel and pick up your worksheets, your pamphlets. This is the week 3 piece. So should be 2 sheets on it. One is gonna say, discovering your spiritual gifts. And the second one is the spiritual gifts cluster. So if you don't have those, you are more than welcome to just jot it stuff down on a piece of paper. Each of the things we're gonna be doing tonight is gonna have you kind of rank things and get a score total. So if you don't have the sheets I just showed you, no problem, but make sure you've got a sheet of paper and something to write with as we start going through these things. So if you don't have one, this is your chance to scramble for 30 seconds and go grab one. So ready, go do that. Get ready to start with that, we're gonna pull up just a little bit of a screen share as we start off our evening together. So let's do it. I love sometimes we get these fantastically old pictures, right? I love this. It's got Pastor Paul baptizing one of the Nelsons, and I'm pretty sure that's Anna that he's baptizing, who is a senior this year, senior in high school, which is just amazing to think about. Every Christian, by virtue of their baptism, is called to serve, right? We are called to make a difference in this world. And God has given us one life, gifted to us, given to us, and we are looking at how can we best serve God with who you have been created to be. And the best way to do that is not to try to put on someone else's gifts or talents that we think are amazing and awesome, but to be ourselves, because God has created us to indeed use the gifts we have been given. God fills us daily, right, with this amazing gift of grace, of mercy, of love, that we would go out and spill that over into the world, right? That the things that God has given us, we don't keep to ourselves. It's this infinite blessing that God gives us. And again, we share that with the world. Now, as Martin Luther thought about breaking this down, you put it into 4 categories, right? We have the responsibility to make a difference, number one, in our family. Number two, in the work that we do. So adults, this is you too, right? Places of responsibility. 3 is in our public life, and 4 in the church. Often we think about how God is calling us just to be active in our church. And Martin Luther said, you know what? That is just the tip of the iceberg. We are called to live out a life of faith in our entire lives, right? Our public life, our church life, our work life, and in our family life. So today we'll be talking a little bit more about what does that mean, right? Using those gifts that God has given us and in what capacity, right? Every Christian by virtue of our baptism has spiritual gifts. It might be easy to think about some of the physical gifts that you have. Maybe you are very athletic and you are very good at playing a sport, or you have this wonderful music talent and you are great at playing an instrument, or you can draw really well, or, you know, just fill in the blank. There are many, many things, many ways different gifts that we have been given. But tonight, we're going to be talking about, again, spiritual gifts. And you might just be thinking already, what the heck are spiritual gifts? And I'll say, glad you asked. Wow. We're going to get to those in just a second. God set aside tasks that will make a difference and be rewarding for you that fit your special design. Again, each of us are created differently, right? If you discover the roles that God wants you to take on, you can find the spot in God's work where you fit in just right. There are four scripture verses that really kind of get to the heart of what we're talking about when we talk about spiritual gifts, one being from Romans, one from Ephesians, and two from 1 Corinthians. And we've got them on the screen in case you don't have your Bible in front of you. We're going to look at Romans 12, 4 through 8. I'm going to encourage all of you to read this out loud at home. So if you've got someone sitting next to you, you can read it to them. Yeah, that's right. Fantastic. So let's read this together. Larson's, I love the catwalk by. That was great. Fantastic. All right, so let's read this together from Romans 12, verses 4 through 8. For as in one body, we have many members, and not all the members have the same function. So we who are many are in one body in Christ, and individually we are members one of another. We have gifts that differ according to the grace given to us. Prophecy in proportion to faith, ministry in ministering, the teacher in teaching, the exhorter in exhortation, the giver in generosity, the leader in diligence, the compassionate in cheerfulness. Right. So those are a few of the spiritual gifts that we're going to be getting into, talking a little bit more in depth about. And we'll look at it from Ephesians 4, 11 through 13 as it talks about it in another way. Again, let's read this out loud to one another, if there's folks sitting around you. Starting with verse 11. The gifts he gave were that some would be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers, to equip the saints for the work of the ministry, for building up the body of Christ. Again, showing that we are not given all the same gifts. It's one Holy Spirit at work, but we all have different gifts and different ways we serve in the world, right, in our church, in the public realm, in family. So cool. Now, the 1 Corinthians verses, which you saw, were probably pretty long. If you want to dive into those later, go for it. We're going to break it down into the few pieces that they really touch on, though. They're talking about, again, the spiritual gifts given to us by God. At work in our lives through the Holy Spirit. We talk about wisdom, knowledge, faith, healing, miracles, prophecy, tongues, and interpretation of tongues. All right, so I'm going to check in with people. Are you still with me? Yes, you're fantastic. So good to see you once again. All right, this is the part where you really get to use. You don't just have to listen to me. You have to listen to me a little bit. My apologies, but you get to do some work at home. If you have your sheet for discovering spiritual gifts, great, pull that out. If you're working with a blank sheet of paper, what you're going to be doing is, say for section one, which is what we're going to do first, there are five parts to it. So write a one, leave a line, and then draw A, B, C, D, and E under one. If that makes sense. So one, and then A, B, C, D, E. Now for each of the statements we're going to read, you're going to score it either a one, two, or three. I know, rocket science right here. All right, so if you agree with the statement wholeheartedly, you're like, yep, that is me, give yourself a three for that letter, whether it's A, B, C, D, or E. Okay, so a three is yes, 100% that's me. A two is you're not sure. Maybe you haven't tried it, but it sounds interesting. And a one would be, that's definitely not you. Again, so three would be a yes, absolutely. Two is a maybe, one is a no. That makes sense, give me a thumbs up. Okay. All right, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna go through five statements that are the A, B, C, D, E. You're gonna give yourself a number, one, two, three, for all of those. And then we're going to add them up, and it's going to give you a total score for number one. So your total score for one is going to be between a 5 and a 15. If my math is wrong, let me know later. But if you did a 1 for each of those, it's going to be a 5. If you did a 3, it's a 15. So your score for one will be 5 through 15. And we'll go on so forth from there on. Make sense? Cool. I'm just going to assume yes, unless people are like waving their arms, doing something fun like that. But if you need to get up and do jumping jacks, that's cool too. All right, I'm going to share the screen again, and we're going to start diving in. And oh, I forgot, this is not just for kids. So parents, this might be really fun for you. It will be super fun for parents to do too. So parents, you can go ahead and do this with your kids and see if you match up kind of the same way on some of these, or if you're like completely different, or, you know, how is it going to work? I don't know. You tell me. So parents, do this too. It's going to be super fun. All right. We're going to share this again. We're going to jump on board. All right. Scroll down. All right. I'm just going to expand this a second. Okay. Waylands, I can see you on the screen. Can you tell me, do you see the screen share right now? Give me a thumbs up if you can see it. Perfect, thank you. All right, so number one, A, I can comfortably talk about my Christian faith with others in a way that makes them comfortable as well. We didn't wordsmith this one very well. I'll try that again. I can comfortably talk about my Christian faith with others in a way that makes them comfortable as well. So if you're like, yes, absolutely, I can do that, give yourself a 3. If you're like, maybe, 2. If it's no, I cannot comfortably talk at all, give yourself a 1 on that. Again, I can comfortably talk about my Christian faith with others in a way that makes them comfortable as well. Score it 1, 2, or 3. All right, part B, here we go. I wish others could understand why my faith is so important to me. Again, if you totally agree with that, that's a 3. If you're unsure, maybe 2. Nope, if that's not you at all, 1. I wish others could understand why my faith is so important to me. Part C. I enjoy many friendships with people who aren't Christians. I enjoy many friendships with people who aren't Christians. 3 is yes, absolutely. 2, maybe, not sure. 1, nope, not true at all. All right, and D, I enjoy studying questions that challenge Christianity. I enjoy studying questions that challenge Christianity. Again, 3 is absolutely yes, that is me. I do that all the time. 2 would be maybe, not sure. 1, no, don't enjoy that at all. And our last question for part one is E. I look for ways to help people understand how their needs can be met through Christianity. I look for ways to help people understand how their needs can be met through Christianity. All right, so you've got our A, B, C, D, and E, you've got them all scored. Now we find out what the category is. Wow, it's like, oh, can you hardly wait? I know, it's so exciting. So I'm gonna share the screen again. What you're gonna do is for part one, where you left that little blank, write the name of this spiritual gift. And behind that, you're gonna total up the numbers from A, B, C, D, and E. So you're gonna write the title and then add up those numbers, and we'll see if it's it's a 5 or a 15, we'll find out. All right. For number one, that is the gift of evangelism. So go ahead and write evangelism under line one. And put your score right behind it. So about the gift of evangelism, it's the ability to spread the good news of Jesus in a way that appeals to those who don't know him, causing people to accept and follow Jesus. For instance, you might wish that other kids could know your God. It's easy for you to invite friends to youth events or a church. You find yourself thinking about and sharing God questions with others. And you can imagine yourself as a missionary, maybe across town or across the world. Cool. So take a second, turn to the person sitting next to you and say, wow, huh, I never thought about that. And maybe, wow, I can totally see why I was a 5 in that category, or I had no idea I would be a 12. What does this mean for my life? Do I need to become a missionary? I don't know. Go ahead though and talk to the person next to you about what your score was on that 5 to 15 range, and how you think that how that might fit into your life. Give you 2 minutes, ready to go. Okay, when I said you had 2 minutes, I meant you had 40 seconds. We're gonna keep moving. All right, this would be number two. So just under where you did one and then A through E, you're gonna write the number two, leave it blank, and then A, B, C, D, E below it. We'll jump right in. Part A, disorganization frustrates me. I want to take over. You know who you are. We love you. Thank you for being organized. All right, three is definitely yes, that is you. Two, sometimes. One, no, doesn't bother you at all. This organization frustrates me. I want to take over. B, if I'm in charge, my friends sense we're headed in the right direction. Three is yes, absolutely. Two, maybe sometimes. One, nope. That is not what my friends are sensing. C, I'm in control of my own time and priorities, or my own belongings or finances. If you are in control of your own time and priorities, or your own belongings or finances, three is yes, absolutely, that is me. Two, yeah, maybe sometimes. One, nope, that is not you. D, I like to organize facts, people, or events. I like to organize facts, people, or events. Again, three is a yes, two maybe, one no. And E, I can lay out the actions needed to deal with anticipated problems. I can lay out the actions needed to deal with anticipated problems. Three yes, two maybe, one no. And the category for section two is the gift of leadership. The gift of leadership. So tally up your score again between 5 and 15 and write that number after leadership on line two. Again, take 30 seconds. Talk to the people next to you about how you feel about your own personal leadership. What do you think? Is that a gift? Is that not a gift? Something you're working on? Something in the middle? Go ahead, take 40 seconds. Oh, quick survey. Students, if you had threes in all those categories, if you were a 15, can you unmute or raise your hand? Anybody have a fifth or like a 13 or higher, 13, 14, or 15? Any students? Unmute or go ahead and raise your hand. Yeah, a couple folks. Okay, how about parents, adults out there? If you were a 13, 14, or 15, raise your hand or unmute and give us a shout out and say, that was me. Yeah, a couple out there. Cool. I'll speak for myself. I love the organized people of the world because you make the world keep moving. So thank you for your work. Keep up the good work. It's hard, especially when you're helping others get organized or get on the same page. That can be sometimes a lot of work. So way to go. You are doing a fantastic job. Keep it up. Okay, we'll move on to our next category. All right. We'll do the breakdown. The gift of leadership, the ability to motivate, coordinate, and direct others doing God's work. People look to you to get things done or to solve a sticky situation. People trust you with responsibility. In a group, you don't dread being appointed the leader. And it isn't about being in charge, but knowing that things head in a good direction if you're in charge. And so leadership isn't always, in fact, most of the time, isn't about just being the person in charge and getting all the glory. It's about making sure things get done and in a way that is really beneficial to everyone. All right, moving on to number three. Again, A, B, C, D, and E await us. A, I don't need to be a leader. I'd rather take on practical tasks. And three is yes, that is me. Two, maybe sometimes. One would be no, that is not me. I don't need to be a leader. I'd rather take on practical tasks. B, I notice little jobs that need to be done and I do them. I notice little jobs that need to be done and I do them. See, when I help with routine tasks, I feel a spiritual link to the ministries of people I serve. When I help with routine tasks, I feel a spiritual link to the ministries or people I serve. Three is agree, two sometimes maybe, one no. D, quietly serving others is fulfilling to me. Quietly serving others is fulfilling to me. And E, I like working behind the scenes and dislike being praised in public for my efforts. I like being behind the scenes and dislike being praised in public for my efforts. Three, strongly agree. Two, sometimes maybe one, that's not me. Three is the gift of helps. Right, being a helper. The ability to work alongside others, seeing spiritual value in the practical tasks that further God's purposes. You may notice when people need help, you do something about it and you like it. You do what needs to be done without others knowing it. You don't need to be a leader, but rather take on practical tasks. Go ahead again, take 40 seconds, turn to the person next to you. How did you score on that 5 to 15 ranking? And how do you think you fit into that? Do you notice it? Do you agree with your score? Whether you're on the lower, mid, or high end about helping others in kind of behind the scenes fashion. 40 seconds, go. All right, we're going to move on to the fourth one. A, I often get a gut feeling whether a situation is good or bad. I often get a gut feeling whether a situation is good or bad. Three, strongly agree. Two, sometimes. One, nope, that's not you. B, I can judge where people are coming from, whether they're real or fake. I can judge where people are coming from, whether they're real or fake. C, I sense whether a book, movie, or presentation will bring people closer to God or push them away. I sense whether a book, movie, or presentation will bring people closer to God or push them away. Three being strongly agree, two being maybe sometimes, one being nope, that's not one of my gifts. D, sometimes I see or think of images that convey God's truth. Sometimes I see or think of images that convey God's truth. Again, a three is that's one of my gifts, I know it. Two, you're not sure, you haven't tried it. Maybe it sounds interesting. One, definitely not one of your gifts. And E, I listen carefully for what God wants me to say to others. I listen carefully for what God wants me to say to others. And that is the gift of discernment and prophecy. Discernment and prophecy. Go ahead and add up your total, 5 to 15, put it next to that topic. Let's learn a little bit more about discernment and prophecy. It's the ability to recognize what comes from God and what doesn't, or to proclaim God's truths in a way that fit current situations with insight into how God wants things to change. You might be the one who says, this isn't right. You just know the message isn't what God wants people to hear, or you have an urge to tell someone something about their lives. You connect a Bible story or verse to a situation or any situation. All right, go ahead. Did you think you had the gift of discernment or prophecy? Turn to the person next to you and share about that. How'd you score in that 5 to 15 range? Discernment and prophecy, how does that fit what you think about yourself? Do you think that is one of your spiritual gifts? Are you using that gift? If it is something you scored high in, take 40 seconds, go. Adults, don't forget to share too. How did you score there? Do you think that's one of your gifts? Is it something you do? Is it something you use? All right, we're going to move on to the fifth one. Letter A, I get upset when others are hurt or rejected. I want to reach out to them. I get upset when others are hurt or rejected. I want to reach out to them. Three being yes, that is one of your gifts, you know it. Two, you're not sure or haven't tried it. Maybe it sounds interesting. Three, definitely not one of my gifts. B, I like to show others how much God loves them. I like to show others how much God loves them. C, others say, I'm a good listener. Others say that you are a good listener. D, I often see the best in others, things they're slow to recognize in themselves. I often see the best in others, things they're slow to recognize in themselves. And E, I see how I can help others and can gain their confidence easily. I see how I can help others and can gain their confidence easily. That is the gift of encouragement and mercy. The gift of encouragement and mercy. Go ahead and tally your points, 5 to 15. Go ahead and put that number right next to encouragement and mercy. Let's learn a little bit more about that gift. It's the ability to see the suffering of others and offer comfort by showing empathy, listening effectively, or acting kindly, helping them heal emotionally, relationally, or physically. Friends know that you're a good listener. Maybe they seek you out because they know you are someone that's going to be there for them. Your heart might be often torn by stories of poverty or illness, things you hear or read about, and you know what to say or do when the chips are down for someone else. You know how to show up. Okay, we're going to take 3 minutes. I'm going to dump you into breakout rooms again. I want you to share in your breakout room so far, what's the one you've scored the highest in? Okay, share what you've scored the highest in, and then did that surprise you? Maybe nothing surprises you. Maybe all of this surprises you. You're going to take 4 minutes in your breakout rooms, and we are going to, ready, go. All right, everyone should have a breakout room they can jump into. Share your highest score so far. got about 30 seconds until the rooms close, so other folks should be joining us in just one moment. Welcome back, everyone. All right. We should be about all back. Great. Hopefully that was a chance to not listen to me talk and to hear one another talk. And you were able to share, maybe you had similar things that you scored high in as other folks. Maybe they were completely different. But thank you for taking time to share that with your fellow students. And again, adults, hopefully you are taking advantage of kind of looking at this as well and seeing where you land. Okay, we were just talking about encouragement and mercy, which was number 5 on our list. We're gonna keep plugging away. We'll move at a little bit faster pace because I know you guys can totally do that. 6A, I can make all kinds of people feel welcome. I can make all kinds of people feel welcome. 3 is yes, you know it, that's a gift. 2, not sure. 1, definitely not one of your gifts. B, I make an effort to connect with new kids at church or school. If you're an adult, go ahead and put in the words adult and work in those two categories. You make an effort to connect with people. C, I seem to know what activities or food will appeal to others. You know what people like. Activities, food, you know how to get them involved. D, if I help with arrangements for a party or event, I think less about what I want than what will make others feel welcome. I'm more concerned about what others want, what will make them feel welcome versus what you want. 3, agree. 2, maybe. 1, not your gift. And E, I see relationships as opportunities to pass on God's love. I see relationships as opportunities to pass on God's love. All right, that is the gift of hospitality. Maybe you figured that out as we were going through those. Let's learn more about that gift. It's the ability to demonstrate God's love by providing others with a warm welcome, food, shelter, or fellowship. You might know how to make other people feel welcome. You reach out to new people at church or at school. Your friends like to gather at your house. You work hard to create a safe place that makes others feel important, right? That is the gift of hospitality. Some folks are fantastic at that. They don't even have to think. It's second nature to them. That is just what they do. Again, a fantastic gift that we can all learn to use and work on a little bit, but maybe you are naturally at that. 7, we're gonna start off right away. A, I know God is faithful even when life seems impossible. Again, 3 is it's one of your gifts and you know it. Yes, that's you. 2, you're not sure, haven't tried it or sounds interesting. 1, definitely not one of my gifts. B, I firmly believe God is active in our lives. I firmly believe God is active in our lives. Score that one. C, my friends tell me I am an incurable optimist. Right? You're always optimistic. Your friends are always telling you you are optimistic no matter what the circumstance. 3, yes. 2, maybe. 1, not your gift. D, if I sense that God is behind a project or idea, I can support it even when others are doubtful. If I sense that God is behind a project or idea, I can support it even when others are doubtful. And E, my personal experiences help me believe in the power of faith. Your experiences help you believe in the power of faith. Go ahead and tally those up. Get your score between 5 and 15. Category 7 is the gift of faith. The gift of faith. The ability to recognize what God wants accomplished. A strong belief that God will see it done no matter how big the barriers are. You might know when God wants something done. When people say it can't be done, Sometimes you can see that God is going to pull it off anyway. Deep conviction or vision about something. And that's the gift of faith, as you rank that between 5 and 15. We're going to keep moving, but again, we want you, when you're done with this evening, done with tonight, to maybe go back and revisit these with your parents, with your students, and spend some more time talking about them. 8, letter A, I enjoy studying the Bible and other resources that help me learn about God. If you enjoy studying the Bible and other resources that help you learn about God. B, I like to learn about new ideas, gathering information so I can pass it on to others. If you like to learn about new ideas, and pass it along. C, I want to relate God's truth to life in a way that helps people grow and develop, not to skewer them with truth, but to help them. D, when I study or hear other teachers, I automatically think about how I might teach the information to others as well. And E, when I talk about what I've learned, others often want to learn more about God. Go ahead and add up your totals there, 5 to 15. How did you rank? Number 8 is the gift of, maybe you already knew this, the gift of teaching. Yes. Gift of teaching. Is that one of your gifts? Let's learn a little more. The ability to understand and communicate God's truths to others effectively so that truth changes lives. You're interested in learning about God, the Bible, and how your faith can help you from day to day. You come up with examples and ideas to make a point clearer. You may already be teaching younger children. Maybe that's something you do. Maybe you're a babysitter. Maybe you used to help teach Sunday school or vacation Bible school. Maybe that is one of your gifts. And 2 kind of breakout points here. 1 is wisdom, the ability to apply God's truths to difficult problems. Right? Knowing the difference between wisdom and knowledge, the ability to understand and use information that might come from natural sources or straight from the Holy Spirit. Right, thinking about how we use the wisdom, the God's truths to work through situations and things in the world, right? Using our own experiences to problem solve, right? Versus knowledge, kind of the nuts and bolts of the information. And then how do we apply that being wisdom? Number 9, A, I handle money well. Again, 3, yes, that's you. That's one of your gifts. 2, you're not sure. 1, definitely not one of your gifts. Remember, parents, you cannot answer this for your student. They get to do it themselves. B, no one has to push me to give to others. No one has to push you to give to others. It's something you do naturally or you enjoy doing. 3 is yes, 2 maybe, 1 would be not your gift. C, it's easy for me to ask others to give to causes I believe in. It's easy for you to ask others to give to causes you believe in. D, I've had creative ideas that helped my family give more money to others. I've had creative ideas that have helped my family give more money to others. And E, giving to a cause or a ministry helps me feel a part of it. All right, go ahead, add up your totals there. 5 to 15, put her on the top line. Number 9 is the gift of giving. Maybe that was very evident and obvious as well. The ability to give of material possessions freely and happily to assist people and further God's causes. Instead of a long list of things to buy for yourself, you're sensitive to how much you already have. and you set aside some of your allowance or earnings to give away. I'm trying to work on this with my own kids, and it's tough, right? When they want to spend everything they have and even what they don't have, something that I can be guilty of at times as well. Yeah, we'll see. How did you score on that one? We've got one left. This is the last one, number 10. All right. I sometimes pray in a language I have never heard before. Again, three, yes, this is one of my gifts. I know it's two, you're not sure. You haven't tried it, but it sounds interesting. Or one would be definitely not one of my gifts. B, I pray for things obviously beyond the natural capacity of people. C, I expectantly ask God to heal people who are sick. D, I have seen God work through me in miraculous ways I can't explain. You've seen God work through you in miraculous ways you can't explain. And E, I focus attention on God, not myself. Go ahead and total up your score, 5 to 15, up by line 10. This is the gift of tongues, healing, and miracles. Yes. So this is maybe one we don't hear about, we don't talk about as much in the Lutheran Church. It's not as much part of the Lutheran tradition, but it certainly is part of the Christian tradition, right? There are many going way back to the time of Jesus. We hear amazing stories of healings, of miracles going on. And we know there are other instances as well of speaking in tongues, praising, giving praise to God. It's the ability to function in ways that are unexpected and even miraculous, not for the sake of bringing attention to yourself, but in order to demonstrate God's powers. Again, as we're talking about speaking in tongues in Acts chapter 2, the apostles, full of the Holy Spirit, spoke to the crowds in various languages, which they did not even know. We hear the tongues of angels of 1 Corinthians, words that fit a language pattern, but it is not an earthly language. There's also, as it talks about, the need of an interpretation for public use. Right? If it's just words that are understandable without someone there to interpret them and share to the public what it is being shared that prays for God, it can be a distraction rather than something that draws people to faith. In healing, we hear the healer focusing their attention on God. They listen to the sick. They often want to pray for the sick, and they celebrate the healing of not just the physical body, but of relationships, of spirit, and of the mind, as well, again, as those physical healings. We are asking folks to remember that this is a gift of God and dare to believe that you all have spiritual gifts and dare to use those gifts the way that God has been calling you to use them in your life. What we're going to have you do as we close out here, that last sheet you have, and if you don't have it, you can be an artiste and recreate it real simple. One large circle in the center, five on the outside. Go back and see what you scored the highest in and put that in the center. Okay, write down what that spiritual gift is. And then what are the other five that you scored the highest in? Okay. And be thinking, again, adults do this too, this will be fun. Think about how it is that those gifts might work together. Adults, maybe if you look at what you are doing now, teaching your kids at home, working from home, having a job outside the home, how are your spiritual gifts being utilized in the life that you live, right? How are these many wonderful things that God has given us, how do we use them? And students, be thinking about this as well. How are you using those gifts God has given you? And what does that mean, especially as you look at in a few years? I don't want to say think about being done with high school, but high school, you guys are almost halfway through, which is, yeah, kind of fun to think about, but kind of scary as well. As you look at what's next, how do you use your spiritual gifts as you live out a life of faith in this world? Yeah. That is our unit on spiritual gifts. Again, we kind of breezed through it tonight, but take some more time to in-depthly look at it, chew on it. Have some questions. Talk to your parents about it. Share if you guys, again, had similar ones for students to parents. Were they similar gifts? Do you have different gifts? How do they all work together? And if anybody wants to stick around, if you've got questions about your faith statements, hopefully those are going well. Hopefully you've started on them, as well as your expression of faith. It's kind of go time. So be thinking about those. And our prayers and thoughts are certainly with all of you as you are working on those. We don't want it to be a stressful time, but we know it does add something to your plate of things to do. So we, as a staff, all continue to think of you and pray for you on this faith journey as we inch closer towards confirmation. With that, we'll close in prayer and we will end our recording for the night. Again, if anyone has any questions and you want to stick around, please do so, but let's pray together. Good and loving God, we give you thanks for all of these students and their families, for the way they have continued to work through difficult situations, difficult times. Lord, for the way you have made yourself known to each and every one of us. Continue to support us and encourage us when things are difficult. And help us to celebrate and recognize joy when it happens and when we run across it in our lives, knowing that you are the source. God, we pray for all of those working on faith statements and expressions of faith, that you would, again, guide them and help them come to find the words that they need to write those pieces. God, all of this in your name we pray. Amen. All right. Thank you all. Have a great night. Again, if you have any questions, you want to check in on anything, stick around and I will be around for a few minutes. You can check in. Thank you all. Have a great night.
Thanks, Paul.
Nice. Bye.